Hey guys, it's Oren here from Tom Miniatures. We've all been in that place where we want to start an army because we love the models look cool, we love the backstory of them is awesome, but you know what, we get the models and we don't know how to paint them. And that's what we are gonna talk about today. I'm gonna give you my best 5 tips on how you can get the best color scheme for your army, which you're gonna love. So let's get started. So the first tip is choose a backstory for your army which you're gonna like. So what is your preference? Would you prefer an army with a lore background, something like the Space Marine, the Ultramarines? You want some of your own Space Marines painted in exactly that official color scheme because you've read the book about them, you read the codex, you think they look awesome, then go for that. Because you're gonna love the army, you're into that backstory, it's really awesome. Or maybe you want to make your own chapter of Space Marine, your own unique army, something which is not from the lore. You want to be different. That's very cool if you can take some models and paint them in a special, in a different color scheme. For Space Marines, maybe you want to do a successor chapter of your own. That's a really cool idea. And now, after you made this choice, whether you want to go with official or something more unique for yourself, think about if they are the good guys or the bad guys. Maybe their color scheme should reflect this. For example, look at the Black Legion. Their army is black. They have a lot of reds. They have strong, powerful colors. This reflects their hatred from their lore. So only by watching these colors, you can visualize what they're standing for. So those blacks and reds, which are so predominant with them, they reflect their hatred, they reflect their warlike temper. The black reflects their black souls, maybe? Something like that, black, dark, it's something unholy. So this goes very, very well with the theme of the bad guys. Now an opposite example is the Eldar army. The Eldars are an elegant, refined, a highborn race, and they show this through their color scheme. They have bright colors, elegant lines, cool designs. Then that's what they transmit. They are very elegant, they are very cool, they are very refined and highborn. And you can take this tip and think about what's the allegiance of your army. The second tip, let's talk about the assembly, because that's what you're gonna start with after deciding what's the theme with your army. Would you prefer, again, a standard army? Do you want the models to be assembled and to look the way they came from out of the box? And that goes very well with the principle that you want a lore-friendly army and something standardized. And again, the opposite idea is to make something unique for yourself. You can start working on some conversions, and that would be a very cool, very unique look for an army. You can search online and you can find a lot of examples for several different factions, and you can get your inspirations from those. And another thing you can do when assembling the models is think about their battle stance. Do you want them to look static, rigid, maybe waiting for something? For example, the snipers from an army, the Pathfinders for Tau. You can make them look very still, waiting to take their shot, or maybe a Storm Surge. Has their feet planted in the earth, ready to unleash the firepower from their cannons. Or you can assemble them in motion, in battle stances. Some models which are on the run or ready to charge an enemy or fighting, and this would look incredibly well on close combat models. The third tip, think about what do they stand for. Are they proud warriors like the Space Marines, which go into battle in bright shining armor with powerful colors to make the enemy fear their colors when he sees them? Or they could like more a guerrilla type warfare in which their armor is camouflaged. They use their surrounding to cover themselves up. What do they stand for? Tip number 4. Think about the painting effects you want to apply on the miniatures. You can paint some really clean models which symbolize that they are either very new to a campaign, to a deployment, or they maintain their armor with a lot of care, or maybe they have been fighting for a long time and they are in the middle of a campaign. They are battle-hardened veterans with a lot of weathering on them, dust, scratches, battle damage, chipped paint and all that. You can paint an army to look very, very battle-weary, and a look like that really tells its own story. Another thing you can do regarding to the effects painted on them is think whether you like or not a cartoonish look for them. A cartoonish look could be something like a lot of glows, a lot of source lighting. For example, a model is going through a city and there's this lamplight which is shining on him also. You can enhance the effect of the lamplight and make it glow on the model even stronger. While this is not very realistic, it surely creates a center of interest for the model, which makes everyone who looks at it to notice this effect. And it's very cool. For example, we've painted a Tau army, which has a lot of source lightning, a lot of weapon glows. It makes them look really technological, futuristic, and it gives this cartoonish futuristic vibe to the army. And last tip number 5, let's talk about the basing. When you start basing your miniatures, think about where are they fighting. Are they on their home planet? Are they in a campaign on another planet? What's the area, the planet, the spaceship? What does the city they're fighting in look like? Maybe thinking beforehand who they are fighting against could give you some ideas on how to base them. Here are some Dark Eldars we painted in a very rusty color scheme. Our customer was looking for a battlefield filled with wreckage. And he said, I want these guys to look like they are fighting Tau Empire and there are bodies everywhere. And that's what we've done here. We have made some cracked earth bases to look like they are fighting a Tau planet. And most of the Tau planets look like they're sand or arid. And besides that, we put a lot of Tau bits on the bases. And this helps a lot to change the feel of this Dark Eldar army. Rather than having it based on simple grass and sand, this adds another element of uniqueness to this army. So, in my opinion, it's a really important step to base them accordingly to their background story and where they are fighting. And again, another tip you can use on the basing is whether if you want them to use camouflage or not. An army which is fighting a guerrilla warfare would have their armor painted in similar colors to the environment. So if you want to paint your army green, make them fight in a jungle. Those are my tips on choosing the best color scheme and theme for painting your army. I hope my point of view really helps you, because I've struggled with this myself in the beginning when I was starting and painting my first armies. But now, when I am painting some models for myself, or when me and the top miniatures team are taking a new commission, we think about it beforehand, how everything goes together and creates a look and a theme for the army. And rather than going for a random color scheme which you found online or you think might look good on an army, that's why it's better to think about all these details before starting to paint and assemble your miniatures. If you want to see more of our tips, we have a tutorials page on our website, topminiatures.com. And if you want to talk with us about commission painting your army, don't forget that Top Miniatures is a company that offers commission painting services. All the pictures in this video are pictures of armies we've finished in the past. And if you like our style, be sure to go on our website to see more galleries of our work, the prices for commission, and contact us directly if you want to talk more about it. And I will leave the links in the description for our social media like Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, and so on. So it's been my pleasure to give you these tips. I hope right now your mind is clear and you have at least a starting idea of how you want to paint your own miniatures. And I will be back to you next week with another tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe and please tell me in the comments how these tips help you to choose the color scheme of your army.